कृषी विपणन आणि रोगासंबंधित माहितीपूर्ण व्हिडिओ बघण्यासाठी कॉटनगुरू यूट्यूब चॅनल सबस्क्राईब करा आणि नवीन व्हिडिओ बघण्यासाठी बेल आयकॉनवर क्लिक करा.
नमस्कार, वेलकम, वणकम ऑल ऑफ यू. और भारत में रहकर इस कार्यक्रम को अटेंड करने वाले एंड ऑल दोज पीपल हु आर आउटसाइड इंडिया स्टिल अटेंडिंग द प्रोग्राम, वेलकम एंड गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. आइए आपस में कुछ बात करें, आइए आपस में कुछ बात करें, कुछ देर यूं ही हम आपका दीदार करें. मिलती है जिंदगी कॉटन और टेक्सटाइल में बड़ी मुश्किल से, फिर क्यों ना मिलजुल कर इसका श्रृंगार करें. व्हाई डू वी हैव टू क्राई अबाउट व्हाट वी डू एवरी डे एंड व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू डू फॉर मोस्ट ऑफ अवर लाइव्स. वी आर ऑल बॉर्न इन कॉटन, बॉर्न इन टेक्सटाइल्स और चूजन कॉटन एंड टेक्सटाइल्स एज अवर फेवरेट सेक्टर और सेक्टर ऑफ चॉइस. सो नाउ व्हाट वी कैन डू इज, यहां से बेहतर क्या हो सकता है. कैन वी लिव एंड लेट लिव, जियो और जीने दो. इस शब्दों को, इन शब्दों को सही अर्थ में हम सार्थक कर सकते हैं. कैन वी रियली प्रूव दैट लिव एंड लेट लिव इज वॉट वी आर हियर फॉर. That is what the human race is here for. Then why not the textile and the cotton supply chain? Why do we have to compete for unnecessary issues with each other? This is the agenda that we come with in this Cotton Conclave 2021. I would like to brief you regarding what has happened in the past cotton conclaves. Just share the screen. So here we go, Cotton Conclave 2021. The name that ICAC has given to this year's World Cotton Day is Cotton for Good. We will also highlight why Cotton for Good and what actually they mean by Cotton for Good. So we start with Cotton Conclave 2018. What was the agenda? Doubling farmers' income. Easier said than done, but that was the agenda we came up with. We had to highlight the burning issues facing the industry and the agriculture sector. The second agenda was reducing the grave disparity in cotton ginning and spinning for the purpose of eliminating adulteration, contamination and malpractices. All this was happening because there was grave disparity, and was there any way or any roadmap that we could come out during this Cotton Conclave 2018 with the brilliant thought leader that we had in that time. Then we came out with a white paper. The white paper released at the end of the conference clearly highlighted what needed to be done. This was circulated to all the industries, government associations, research associations, many of them validated it and accepted it. The main issue that came out was agriculture by design. Is it possible to give demand in advance so that the farmers can plan their agriculture? That is surely possible, I think. And awards were distributed for best farmers, best ginners. The ginner that you see in the picture below on the left side is making contamination-free cotton now. So this was the outcome of 2018 Cotton Conclave. Then came Cotton Conclave 2019. Agenda, unlocking the economic potential of cotton. Making cotton and textile industry the darling of investors. The plethora of invitees to this event was farmers, ginners, spinners, brands, government officials, and investors. Those were added in this year. Investors came and they shared what they needed so that they could invest in the textile industry. And one exceptional thing happened during that event was there was a live auction. Some farmers came with the kapas and Pasha Bhai Patel leaded them, and we auctioned that kapas at 500 rupees above the market price. Then came Farmathon 2019 on World Cotton Day. World's first ever farmers marathon to celebrate the World Cotton Day. 500 farmers from across Maharashtra gathered and they ran. The farmers actually ran the marathon. 65 women ran the marathon, and this was highlighted in so many, about four news, TV news channels and over 15 print media. the event was a success with the farmers because the agenda was, yes, we are ready. Is the industry ready? There was no demand, no subsidy asking, nothing, but only to show that we are ready. And this is just a glimpse of what the leading newspapers publish regarding the event. BSC was the main supporter of the event. CCI supported the event. There were many people who supported. Suresh Bhai Kotak had blessed and totally guided us throughout this event at what was best possible. Natural colored cotton garments were launched during this event also. They were designed differently for all occasions, for all genders, and they were launched during this event. That was another happening for that event. Then we come to Cotton Conclave 2020. Branding of cotton value-added products. Amul model. Everybody knows Amul is a milk product company, but Amul model is a very, very fantabulous model, and we advocated that there should be an Amul model in cotton for White Revolution 2.0. Creating small models for reprints. How can we start? We can start by creating small models. And awards were given to farmers like last time, but this time we added farmer producer organizations. Yes, we did want farmer producer organizations to be part of the journey of the cotton supply chain, and hence these awards were announced for them. Fantastic representation, about 100 farmer producer companies applied and 3 were awarded. Cotton Conclave 2021. What do we have now? Cotton for good, as I said. Why, what for, and what difference can it make to our lives is what we are going to discuss today. Unlocking the socio-economic potential of sustainable agriculture for global prosperity. I invite you to focus on these two new words, socio-economic, not only economic. Our responsibility also lies socially. So we have added that concept and global prosperity with sustainable agriculture. Does that have any link? The thought leaders today will deliberate and share their expertise on this subject and branding India. So cotton for good. We see what is happening around the world. Climate change is causing havoc. What was happening is decades is happening in months now. Forest fires, droughts, cyclones, typhoons, excess rainfall, and without warning. What can change is cotton. Cotton is a sustainable fiber, a breathable fiber, a thermostatic fiber, heat conductor, whatever you say, everybody knows, but very few of us believe, can cotton do something for climate change? It certainly can. We will also highlight some points during this Cotton Conclave 2021. What are those aspects? I invite you to one more innovative product. Like I said, creating models like Amul. The small model has been started by Cottonguru. It is the Cottonguru Pradeshan Khet or Model Farm and Training Center. We have them across India. In every project that we do, we have one such model farm, but we have developed a very large scale farm this year. 35 acres in Ghatanji, 100% rain fed area, 100% tribal area, where we have developed this model farm, and it is for everybody to see. Everybody is welcome to visit that place and have a look what is happening there. Big Villa farmer trainings, farm level trainings, and technology implementation is happening. This is the current photo on the left side of the farm. In spite and despite of heavy cyclonic rains, the wettest September in history of that place, we were still able to do something, because here we work on soil, seed, climate change, agriculture, every experiment that we have ever thought of, we try to implement on this farm. And last comes contamination-free cotton. The picking that will happen. This is one of our other farms where this picking has happened, and we will do similar type of contamination-free cotton picking, processing, and baling in this Cottonguru Pradeshan Khet model project also. What have we done for the corporates? Yes, if you are a corporate, if you're willing to get into agriculture, modern commercial agriculture is the need of the hour, is also the flavor with the so many brands and corporates, turnkey project for corporates and brands. One of the example is a 100 acre plot we developed for a corporate last year. Barren land, 100%. You can see the tree on the backside. Not a single leaf, 3 years of drought, and 5 months down the line, you can see this actual photograph of that farm. Everything is recorded, documented, even by TV channels. So a good opportunity definitely for the corporates to get directly involved in the supply chain. The newness that we try to incorporate here and bring to your notice is, please give significance to farmer producer organizations. They are your vehicle to success. If you have to work with farmers, it is not possible to work with individual farmers. So we made a Cottonguru Maha FPO Federation. It's a farmer producer company under which there are over 100 farmer producer organization. Under them are over 1 lakh farmers, and some farmer cooperatives and women self-help groups. It helps them integrate into a very strong branded approach, a professional approach, and a market face. So what we started with Cotton for Good People, that is the social responsibility, planet, environmental responsibility, profit, economic responsibility. All of this are incorporated in Cotton for Good. Cotton justifies all three of them. And we, as a Cottonguru Parivar or a Cottonguru family, advocate strongly that yes, cotton is the most sustainable and renewable resource that we have. 50% to 60% of the spinning industry uses cotton, 80% of the fiber usage, natural fiber usage across the world is in cotton. So it is a very strong pitch for cotton, which it itself justifies. Thank you for being patient during this presentation. So now I will invite you to have a look at a small film that was taken during the Farmathon 2019, which was telecast live in Geneva during the World Trade Organization celebrations there. I was one of the invitees there. I could not manage to go, I said, because it was only for 2 minutes that they might have allowed me to speak there, but I took their permission and we officially hosted the Farmathon in Aurangabad that was telecast live there. Please have a look at that event. It will highlight whatever I have said during the last 10 minutes to you.
On the eve of World Cotton Day today, here's a surprise for the global cotton industry. We are all set to produce as much cotton that can cater to the entire global demand with a quality that can match global standards. Wondering who we are? We are India's cotton farmers. World Cotton Day is incomplete without the participation of cotton farmers. Similarly, a country's economy is fragile without growth in agriculture. How Indian cotton is different than others. India grows all four species of cotton, which are suitable to spin yarns from 2 to 160 counts. Majority of the cotton is hand-picked and roller gin, which is most preferred by spinners across the world. India is the largest producer of conventional cotton and organic cotton. India is the most geographically suitable cotton supplier, with above 65% of world consumption happening in and around India. India has over 38% of global land in cotton cultivation, so there is immense potential to contribute as a reliable supplier of quality cotton to support the global consumers. Nearly 60 million people are employed in cotton cultivation, marketing, processing, and exports. Cottonguru, with its 116-year-old history as a fourth generation, has been associated with cotton from farming to exports, having a direct network of over 50,000 farmers across India. We are into Pradarshan Khet, or evidence farming projects, which are an integrated effort involving India's best farmers, corporates, seed companies, agri-input companies, farm tech companies, to convert barren fields to fertile, profitable farmlands. In this, our team of experts stays with the farmers and guides or trains them from sowing to marketing, helping them increase yield and enhance their income. With a rich experience in cotton grading and marketing, Cottonguru is India's one and only certified cotton valuer. On behalf of over 12 million cotton farmers in India, Cottonguru assures the global consumers and traders that we are sincerely working on enhancing the quality quotient as well as quantity quotient. While you are attending this conference on the World Cotton Day today, we have been organizing Farmathon, a first of its kind farmers marathon in the world, to promote cotton as the most natural sustainable and eco-friendly renewable resource and fully encash its utility value. In collaboration with Sercot Research Institute as developer, Kota Commodities as incubator and Cottonguru as the designer, we are soft launching our unique range of garments made from sustainable and eco-friendly naturally colored cotton. Yes, you heard it right. Naturally colored cotton manufactured without using dyes and chemicals, with the wholehearted support by the Indian government for promoting Make in India cotton and value-added textiles. Cottonguru invites you all to join us in our mission of encashing the economics of cotton for global prosperity. Let us use more and more cotton and replace plastic and paper bags with cotton bags and tissue paper with cotton handkerchiefs, so as to support the cotton farmers and protect the environment and our future generation. Let us make cotton the white gold again and make cotton farming to fabric business a traceable, profitable and a sustainable model.
Easier said than done. A traceable, sustainable and still profitable. All these three words together, put together, can mean the world for every industry and for the farmer also. But is it possible? And if it is possible, how? And what should we do is the main content of today's event.